new beginning and a new shared life together for George and I. And we hope that, you know, you will take part in that shared life, because all of you have been really, really important to us, and that's why you're here today. I want to say a big thank you again to Lowry, my niece and bridesmaid, for being... bridesmaid. And to Sue, her mum, for steadying my nerves. For coming early. She's my sister and she's been just a brilliant support to me. To Simon and Tina for being brilliant ushers. And my mum for giving me away something I'm sure she never thought and I never thought she would have to do. And a really fantastic speech as well, one that I have to live up to now. Also my sister Jane, who couldn't come today, just would have been too much for her. But she made us a beautiful cake, which is over there. I hope you will enjoy it later. And her husband, Jeffrey, helped too. She's very sorry that she couldn't be here. And I know that George's family are sorry too that they couldn't make it. I would have loved to share the day with them. I would have loved to share the day with my dad too. Who I know would have loved George. I think he would have really loved talking to him, and also he would have loved taking the mickey out of you. He would have loved telling him how many gardeners Arthur Scargill has. So they might not have seen eye to eye politically, but I think they would have got on in other ways. Also, I'd really like to mention my friend Amanda, who was wonderful and also enjoyed being here. Her kids are here, and that's fantastic. I'm really pleased. And lastly, I want to say how lucky I am to have so many fantastic friends, and I want to big up the women friends at the moment. I've just got so many brilliant, inspiring, supportive friends. Kat, who I've known since I was 11. Brenda and Jackie, who were on strike with me for a year and have done lots of things since. But that was a good moment. Tina, Sarah, and Bronwyn, who plays fantastic. And Ella from Brighton. And Chris, who works with me now, puts up with all my moans. And so many, I mean, all the women in the room, basically. I couldn't have chosen a best woman. It would have been impossible. I did try, and I thought about it, and I just decided it was too much. So I didn't ever expect to be signing a marriage certificate. But George, as you know, is a very special man. I think he's proved tonight how special he is in lots of ways. And I'm really looking forward to spending a future with him. And actually, I see that future as encompassing everybody who is here. And I want to make a toast to love and to friendship. I haven't got love.